It's an irony that I speak on the behalf of any of this motion. We have to see this debate on three questions. First question, whether or not this is justified, whether it is okay as a proposal to be taken by a legitimate government. Secondly, ladies and gentlemen, how good the impact will be to the movement of these homosexuals. And lastly, how good this impact of that will be implicated to the children's life. That is the three questions that I propose in this debate. So the first question, ladies and gentlemen, what the negative theme offering to you is a simple explanation. Look, this is a value that is not to be accepted in the society. Let us continue the discrimination in this new. Let us continue the status in which you are not being given equal rights to adopt the children. We are asking the question systematically. One, why do you think this is a good value for you to differentiate people on the basis of only of their sexuality? They never answer that. We ask you the question why it could be different if the father and the father are the one who's raising you as a children. They never answer that. They only say it might confuse the children. Well, it's status quo. Some heterosexual families are confusing the children when they're becoming drunkard, when they're becoming, prostitution is not religious offensive. Ladies and gentlemen, these are problems with families. We can't never be sure of you having always having a good family. But the problem is, ladies and gentlemen, we can't never assume that homosexuals are always a bad family, ladies and gentlemen. The status quo stipulates that. That's why we're going to change the status quo, because we want them to be stripped out the right of parenting when they are proven to be bad parents, ladies and gentlemen. If we have to give them chance, because they are citizens, and because this is a constitutional right to the pursuit of happiness. We have given you the analysis why children is massively important as the continuations of the lineage, but more importantly, as someone who you raise by your hand, who you're giving toys to, who can take care of you back in the old time, ladies and gentlemen. These are the sensitive value of children that they never really touch, ladies and gentlemen. Why can we deny this right? This fundamental right when the values of societies are against it. That's the massive thing which we call as ridiculous. But secondly, bottom line is, so let's deal with the value in society. My question to the negative thing is, how is your proposals are going to contribute a positive improvement to the homosexual movement, ladies and gentlemen? Because your proposals are basically not doing anything, basically confirming the society's stigma, are basically validating society's concern of whether or not gay are good parents, ladies and gentlemen. You're not helping anything. So when can this change happen? Because this is a massive, inconsistency. Adi had said we should oppose this at all, and the second speaker said we are not ready yet. When can we ready, ladies and gentlemen? And why is that your proposals are going to fix this? We say that our proposals are going to fix this in two ways. Firstly, ladies and gentlemen, we have given the children the consent to be able to participate in this family, and the children will be able to do so and will be able to pursue better future, ladies and gentlemen. This will create an example within the society. This will create a good stories, inspirational stories about how homosexuals can even raise, a Pamela Anderson or maybe, some sort of like Nobel inventor or something, ladies and gentlemen. This is what we need to make sure that society are changed in terms of images, in terms of prejudices. Why your proposal or basically not doing anything change this? It's a massive confusion for the affirmative thing. But the last rebuttal, ladies and gentlemen, the impact to the children. They say that the consent are not enough. Children are not as rational as people, as, we say yes. That is basically why we add the second mechanism, which in this case, the orphanage has to do tests and screening to make sure that the parents are suitable, ladies and gentlemen. Why could this mechanism being added are not able to assist their children in making good decisions? They never tell me why. They only say children should never make decisions when they are children just because their age are not sufficient. We think, ladies and gentlemen, children has the choice. When their choice is between having a family or being raised in the orphanage alone without no love, ladies and gentlemen. Because the idea of being special, the ability to feel special, the ability to always be bought toys, to always be prioritized over other kids, are the exclusive right of the children. So why state can continuously deny that right is massively an understatement in this debate of human life. So at the end of the debate, I beg you to propose.